patient. I have a message for you. God has sent me to you. I have a message for you. God has sent me to you. Listen, them say, them tell you say, say you can never be the one. But God say, make I tell you say, say now you him choose. In 1 month, in 1 week, you will sing a new song. In 2 days, a lesser than you will hear. Congratulations, you're seeing the glory of God. Congratulations, he has done it for you. And you will come back with a new song to sing. God is good. Yes, you will come again with a new song of praise. God is good, oh.
Jesus' name, amen. Now we are about to start. We are starting with our grand entrance. Thank you. Thank you.
the 2023 grade A graduation ceremony. Woo.
From the book of Jeremiah chapter 29 verse 11, which reads as follows: "For I know the plans I have for you, this is the Lord's declaration, plans for your well-being, not for disaster, to give you a future and a hope." Join me as I lead you in prayer. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you this wonderful morning as we approach the throne of grace. We submit your kingship, we submit your lordship. Almighty Father, we are here gathered for one reason, to celebrate with our children as we are stewards. You've given us these children in our care so that we can nurture them to become future leaders, to become better people of tomorrow. We thank you, Almighty God, for the year that we had, a wonderful year, as we are now here to celebrate with them their achievements. We pray, oh God, that you continue to guide them, you continue to lead them, you continue to teach them, for you are the great teacher, oh God. We thank you, Almighty Father, as we are starting with our program today. May you be in each and every item that is on the program as you increase, oh Lord. We decrease. We thank you for everything. Take over control and take charge. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Mr. Musa A, for such a powerful prayer. Next up, I would like to welcome grade R learners who are coming to welcome us all. Let's give them a big round of applause as they come to our stage.
My name is Ofuna Stad.
like to welcome our teacher, Miss Nuria Ra'ai, who is coming to tell us why we are gathered here.
Oops, I almost said let's give her a big thunder.
Ah, do you think they know what is a thunder?
Don't worry, let me explain it to them. Ladies and gentlemen, a big thunder is coming from Foundation Faith. When we give someone a big thunder, we clap once, like this. May we please try? Let's give Miss Munoriawa a big thunder.
Thank you very much, our beautiful program directors. I would like to take this moment to greet everyone in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. Allow me to acknowledge the presence of our principal, Mr. Rachibumo, and our deputy principal, Ms. Nematatani. I would, in a special way, would like to greet our special guest, dear parents, our graduates, prefects, colleagues, members of SMT. I'm very pleased to be given this opportunity to speak today, considering the journey that we walked with our graduates this year. Today is a very special day for our 2023 Grade R class, and also for their proud teachers and their proud parents. This is because our learners have successfully completed their school readiness program. Like you heard the song that we are repeatedly playing, I'm Ready to Go. This ceremony can be divided into three components. Number one, it's a celebration. And what are we celebrating? We are celebrating a time for looking back on lessons learned, the adventures that we shared with our learners, the bright moments that has a special meaning. Number two, it is a farewell to what? To the Grade R daily routine. The Grade R learned through a routine that is a bit different from the other grades. And they are saying farewell to that routine because they are going to a more formal learning setting. This routine greatly was made up of playing, singing, and of course the afternoon naps. So they are saying goodbye to all that. Number three is a beginning. This is a time for looking forward to grade one, a time to set new goals, to dream new dreams, to try the new things, and see what lies beyond. Ladies and gentlemen, this is a momentous succession in the lives of our children. And it is also time to recognize the outstanding work of the teachers and parents. As I walked down memory lane in January, when the children came to school, I know most parents were worried. There was separation anxiety, but look at us, we are here today, our children are ready. The teachers taught them to read, they were taught to write, they were taught to build relationships, they were also taught to love God and to love people. We watched our children learn, grow, and change from day to day. And I am very confident that all the things we have done as teachers are helpful in every way. Today, we showcase just a glimpse of what they learned in the school. And I would like to humbly welcome you to relax, celebrate, cheer up, ululate for our graduates. Thank you very much.
Next up, I would like to call out the children as the main reason we are here to do their presentations.
Hello everybody, we are here to recite our poems.
My sentence. I see with my eyes, I hear with my ears, I taste with my tongue, I smell with my nose, I touch with my hands. Thank you.
Who am I? I am white with spots and brown and black. I like to eat hay and grass for snake. And I chew and chew and chew. When I don't eat, I say moo, moo. And I will give you my cake.
Twinkle, twinkle, traffic light. Round the corner shining bright. Red means stop. Green means go. And yellow means go very slow. Twinkle, twinkle, traffic light. Round the corner shining bright. Take.
Hello. I'm going to recite a song for you. Do you know the Appleman, the Appleman, the Appleman? Do you know the Appleman? He likes to sing with me.
Hello everybody, my name is Hugo and I'm gonna recite a song for you. Do you know the Appleman, the Appleman, the Appleman? Do you know the Appleman? He likes to sing with me.
Hello everybody, my name is Sepiso. I want to recite a poem for you. Tinkle, tinkle, traffic light, round the corner shining light. Red means stop, green means go. And yellow means go very slow. Tinkle, tinkle, traffic light. Round the corner, shining light. Thank you.
In the get your popcorn ready.
Thank you.
for you.
Hello, everybody. My name is Ria Betty. This is South African Airways. Flying you is pilot Ria Betty. Enjoy your journey. Thank you.
Two!
Justomale
in Zambia, where he got his diploma in theology in 1986. He went on to further his studies at the University of Pretoria, where he graduated with a BA honors in theology in 2004. In 2005, he went on and attained a master's in practical theology at the same University of Pretoria. He did not end there. The man I am talking about is a doctor. In 2011, our guest speaker graduated with a PhD in practical theology at the University of Pretoria once again. He is not just a pastor, a husband, a father, and a doctor. He is also an author with three books on his name. Above that, he worked as a moderator of the United Presbyterian Church in Southern Africa from 2016 to 2018. Currently, he is serving as a pastor at Goodwill Mission. Our guest speaker is none other than Pastor Reverend and Dr. Robert Montali. May we all please welcome the doctor on stage with a thunder.
Greetings to all of you in the wonderful name of our Savior and Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. I stand here today to speak to you, but before I speak to you, I want us to see the importance of a pedagogy, a teacher. It is said that people went to a hotel. And when they went to that hotel, each and every person was bragging, was being braggadocious about what they had achieved in life. The other one said, I am a surgeonist, a neurosurgeonist that can take out the spinal cord and remake it. The other one said, you see those skyscrapers? I'm the one who drew the plan. The other one said, all the animals, I'm the zoologist. I know about all animals. The other one said, I'm a botanist. All these things that you see, the fauna and the flora, I am the man. Now there was an old man there. Then they pointed him and said, what about you? Everybody else has said who they are. Say who you are. And he says, I taught him. What can I say? The noble profession of a teacher. When it's a pedagogy, always a pedagogy. When you handle the most finest of what God has created, you have been blessed. Why are teachers noble? Because of all that God has created, it's like when we come down here, we are a tabula rasa. I know when I began to read and write, it was in the sand where they taught us how to write in the sand. When you graduate from the sand, you used to go to a tablet where you start writing now the real things. I don't know how many are as old as I am who use that system. We started writing in the sand, we graduate from the sand, we write on the tablet, all because of a teacher. So today I'm also having an opportunity that the same teachers have been given to begin with the human brain, not only to make it literate, but to banish illiteracy by teaching them to read and write. We have seen the alphabet. Those of us that are into the Bible, we know that the Hebrew Bible or the Hebrew alphabet has got, you read the Psalms, they'll tell you all the letters that are in the alphabet for the Hebrew. It's only 22. If you go to the Greek alphabet, it's 24. You go to the English alphabet, it's 26. And none of us can write anything without the alphabet. In fact, all the letters that we have, all these certificates we have following us, they are written down in the alphabet. So, a teacher, especially these who we are gathered about today, are very special because this is the rudiment of all learning. There can be no learning without this. And the government in South Africa has taken it very seriously for early childhood education. And the Christian schools are also helping the government in imprinting these things that education is critical. Before they can come to the formal learning, they must do the learning in the sand, in the play, in the games, and making their muscles to grow. And this is why it is very critical to always, always, always uphold the teacher in the highest esteem, because it is a noble task. And I know some of you here are teachers, some are parents, but let us just stand and clap for the teacher, because they imprint, they are in co-workers with God, doing the impossible. If we want to have good citizens, a teacher and God and the parent must work together so that the end result can be pleasing not only to the nation, to the Lord who made them. Just rise and clap for the importance of the teacher in this journey of learning that begins from these humble rudiments. Let us just stand and clap. Don't be jealous, clap for the teacher. The teacher is a special person. Thank you very much. Now, in the Greek, that's why those who do teaching, they do didactics. Now, in the Greek, the word is didache. That's where the word teacher comes from. And the reason for a teacher is to banish ignorance. So if you are a teacher and you are not chasing ignorance from the hearts and the minds of people, then you have failed to be a teacher, because the teacher's duty is to banish ignorance. And they say our continent had a problem of underdevelopment and a problem of illiteracy, problem of disease, poverty and hunger. And it is only the teacher who can thoroughly lift us out of these doldrums. That's why we need to respect the teacher all the time. Now, teacher, you are holding the highest material and you are writing on it, the human brain. You are writing things that were not there before. And these little people will behave like you, whatever you have written there. They said the mistake of a doctor is in the coffin, but I don't know the mistake of a teacher where it is. Maybe it is in the society there, for those who you didn't write properly on the... However, today, I read to you a text in the Old Testament and in the New. In the Old Testament, just hear me right. I like this Old Testament text because it is practical. It is practical. It helps us to understand, but also it helps us to realize that these are life issues we are dealing with. There's Proverbs, and I read from Proverbs, although my main text is in the New Testament. I read, "My son, do not forget my teaching, but keep my command in your heart, for this will prolong your life many years and bring you prosperity. Let love and faithfulness never leave you. Bind them around your neck. Write them on the tablet of your heart, and then you will win favor and a good name in sight of God and man. Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge Him, and He will make your paths straight. Do not be wise in your own eyes. Fear the Lord and shun evil. This will bring health to your body and nourishment to your bones. Honor the Lord with your wealth, with the first fruit of all your crops, and then your barns will be filled to overflowing, and your vats will brim over with new wine. My son, do not despise the Lord's discipline. Do not resent His rebuke, because the Lord disciplines those He loves, as a father does the son he delights in. Blessed is the man who finds wisdom, the man who gains understanding, for she is more profitable than silver." Wisdom in the Old Testament is depicted as a woman. That's why the "she" is used for wisdom here. "For she is more profitable than silver, and yields better returns than gold. She is more precious than rubies. Nothing you desire can compare with her. Long life is in her right hand, and in her left hand are riches and honor. Her ways are pleasant ways, and all her paths are peace. And she is a tree of life to those who embrace her. Those who lay hold on her will be blessed. By wisdom, the Lord laid the earth's foundation. By understanding, he sets the heaven in place. By his knowledge, the depth was divided, and the clouds dropped the dew. My son, preserve sound judgment and discernment, and do not let out your, do not let them out of your sight. They will be life for you, an ornament of grace on your neck, and then you will go your way in safety, and your foot will not stumble. When you lie down, you will not be afraid. When you lie down, your sleep will be sweet, and have no fear of sudden disaster. In the New Testament, I read this short text from the Gospel of Luke. It's this, the Gospel of Luke is the only heathen writing with his Jews. And Dr. Luke writes to us in chapter 2. He is the only one who took time to capture the story of the missing years of our Lord Jesus. And this is what he tells us, chapter 2, and I read from 49. And this is what the scripture teaches us. Verse 49 of chapter 2. Why were you searching for me? He asked. Didn't you know that I had to be in my Father's house? But they did not understand what he was saying to them. And then he went down to Nazareth with them, was obedient to them, and his mother treasured up all these things in her heart. And Jesus grew in wisdom, stature, and in favor with God and with man. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Amen. Now, those, the pediatrics, they teach us a little things about growing up the child, and they tell us these things. They say when a child is born, the first month, their weight increases, but 0.170 kg only. And after that, in 3 months, the weight increases to 5 kg. Take notice, this little somebody begins to recognize the mother and responds to her smile. And she smiles with pleasure and plays with her, his own hands and feet, and sleeps 18 hours to 20 hours a day. Day has got 24 hours. Person sleeps all that long. This is the little baby. At 6 months, the weight is 7.5 kg. And the eyes can follow around. Those people who are walking, the eyes can follow them. There is a person going that way. This is a little somebody. And this little somebody can also determine the direction from which the sound is coming. If it's this way, then know that the sound is from here. If it's this way, the sound is from here.
at 6 months can enjoy new tests, take solid food and begin to chew and drink from a cup. At 1 year, probably would be 10.5 kg. The toddler looks around freely and eats most of the food which the family is eating and chews very well. And the need for sleep there is from 12 to 16 hours a day. At 2 years, however, this child needs a lot of love, sympathy, and sincerity from the parents. They need to be helped because it is in here where the character is being built. It is in here where the little person is being helped to have a sense of having friends and relationships. This is why they say that at this age of 1 year, don't crush or mock the friendship that this little person brings to you at the age of 2 years. And then when you give them what to play with, give them stronger things, because nowadays if a car or the truck is not of wood, they will break it and crush it because they are trying to experiment things. If they are girls, they are trying to cook. They are trying to go shopping. They play doctor. They try to learn how to dress. And here, the most important thing is that help them to develop emotionally, because you are making a person at a very rudiment. From this age to 5 years old, this is what you are dealing with on a daily basis. You are in a tripartite and in a relationship. It's parents, teachers, and the learners themselves. But above all, you are co-workers with the master maker himself. He is using you to make citizens that will be reliable. Through these rudimental beginnings, serious things are being done. But look what the scripture teaches about Jesus in his childhood and boyhood. They say he grew up in stature, that is physically, he was growing. And those who teach us about holistic understanding of a human being, they say that human beings are not only physical, but physical well-being is important. Health for physical is important. And in our modern times, because parents are busy, everyone is busy, then even the children sometimes are given over more to the teachers than to the parents. And you find that in that situation itself, something is missing, the diet. So you find the children being given easy diets that are in terms of food, junk food. And when they have junk food, they come to school, they just sleep, because junk food doesn't do anything good. So dear parents, I implore you in the name of the Lord, give children zliwa. Zafushi. I don't know if I'm saying it right there. Good food, which is for protein, for building their brain, because as they grow to learn better, they need that protein. They need the carbohydrate for energy. They also need the protective, for them to be protected. They are growing, so don't give them to the market person who is interested in their 5 rand which you give them for care. Give them food at home. Then this growth, you will enhance it. Proper food. Vamweva baby nari, asim koyanga yo bika. Kama kombeche zo uliwa jene chukoro cho bika wa bika ne zuliwa zwa fushi halani. because it is the only way we can grow these little ones. And these little ones are the little people, the future people of tomorrow. And if we grow them well, physically, they will be good people. The second stage that Jesus is said to have grown is he grew in wisdom, meaning the intellectual capacity and mental capacity. And many of the schools, they are busy doing that. Even the universities are busy doing that. Now, the danger of that is that you may have a graduate who's got a very big head and thin limbs, because intellectually up to date, but it's not balanced because it's not holistic. So, as much as you are dealing, teachers, you are dealing with the mind, remember also that a human being is holistic. The other aspect of a human being is that he is a social being. Jesus grew in favor with God, but also in favor with man. Meaning that the socialization that happens in a school, it cannot be replaced by anything. That's why once a teacher, always a teacher, but also no one can be greater than his teacher. You shall always salute your teachers. This is why these children, as they grow, teach them to socialize, because we are social beings. But as they socialize, they build relationships which may last for a lifetime. Jesus grew as a social being. Atakaleronga batu, meaning people could relate with him. But also he did not only grow that way, he also grew that atakaleronga mzini. The relationship is a spiritual being. Many people, they only become serious about their spirituality when they attend a funeral. But the rest of the times they do their own thing, they have no need for God. They are those we can say, they don't believe in a God. They don't have business for a God. But when things become serious, they try to say a prayer, a little bit of a prayer. We are spiritual beings. Take care of your spirituality as you take care of the spirituality of these little people that God has given in our care. And only so, if we are to be holistic, they say, when the Lord created the heavens and the earth, as you read in Genesis, the biosphere was made where life stays, but he brought in all the things that can support life, meaning the environment. Man was made in his environs so that he can be able to please God, to take care. But modern man has devastated the world. Even the seasons have changed. The rain doesn't come properly. The winter doesn't come properly. The spring and the summer, they do not come properly, because we have been tampering with the canopies that God put around to protect us. The stratosphere has been damaged, and so now the heat is too much. And a few days ago, I thought maybe we are being cooked. But it is us who do not care for the biosphere. When God himself, he created man, that man must take care of all these things. Good people, these children, we must teach them in a holistic sense. But if I am to come now to the protection that we have, they say, we are living at a time when knowledge has escalated, especially when the computer came in. It's almost, we can do almost everything with a computer. As much as there are positive things that we learn from computer. Those of us who are in research, they tell us that not everything in the computer is literally factual. So you must only go to websites which are academically considered to be right. Even for our children, we must protect them from bad social media. Because when we leave them to those vices, they will be destroyed. Here in the vices, you can find there is pornography that destroys. I'm reminded of a story of two brothers who made a $1 billion industry through pornography. But when they got converted, they went to that warehouse and touched it and touched it and touched it to destroy it. Why? Because as much as sexuality is a gift of God, it must not be perverted. When it is perverted, then it destroys everything. Now, these children of ours, we give them so much power through the handset, this handset. When we give them all the data and we destroy them, because when we are busy sleeping, they are going to all the wrong networks. And those networks do not give them anything good than destruction. The scripture tells us, the thief comes only to steal, kill, and destroy. And that thief is the enemy of our souls, the devil. And let's protect our children from these bad media influences. Even in our country, all of us listen to news, but not everything we listen to is really factual. Some of those things are doctored. And when you swallow them as gospel truth. If they want you to hate a certain person, they will tune it to go that way. If they are in political battles, they use the media. So not everything media necessarily must be swallowed. Scrutinize it. Search viable facts. And research, one of the statements which is very critical is scientific. If they tell you this is scientific, they simply mean it's factual. It is not some fact. It is not a thing which is willy-nilly or lackadaisical. It is something that has been. So let's give our children a life that they will be protected from these vices that destroy them. Life, from the text I read, shun evil. And for our children also, help them to shun evil and keep them safe from evil influences. Because we want them to grow up as human beings who are solid citizens that are patriotic, but also effective. Not necessarily that they take everything that like. It is dangerous out there for little ones. We need to protect them. And every mother and father must know what their children are up to. Just know what is going on around them. Know their friends. Know what they are doing. Just know where they are, so that you can save them, because we are in a dangerous time. You may be with a child just there, but you are worlds apart. You may find what technology has done is mother and father, children, and each one, instead of having quality time, each one is on their handset, scrolling. Instead of having an effective conversation that can build a home, everyone has gone to the media, and the things that they are looking at, they're not even helpful. Please, please, please. This thing has got the good side if we come academically, but it has also got a wrong side. If we go to the vices that are put in here by all the scavengers and those suspicious people who are trying to destroy our minds. The battle we have now is for the minds. Who controls the mind? And therefore, let's safeguard our children from bad media influence. Let's safeguard them because they are living in the most dangerous time. We lived in the times of innocence, but let's guard their innocence seriously so that when they come up to these things that this media portrays, we may see that we are co-workers with God. When we look at the end product, we must say, God and us, we did a good thing. May the Lord help us. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
If you want to judge us, look at the program directors. I love to watch court processes. The judges would say courts are responsible for controlling their own processes. So these kids are in the foundation phase. They are in charge of their own school, their own phase. They are running their program. They're in grade 3. They are running the program for their younger brothers and sisters. So that's how you should judge us. We are offering education that works. These kids have confidence that many of us don't have or never had at their age. And we appreciate you girls. Thank you for the confidence that you have demonstrated. And Ref, thank you. I've never told you, you are one of the pastors whose teachings I love so much. I'm very selective. I'm a very selective person. So he is one of the pastors whose teachings I love. That's why we invite you so often. There was a time when you were not available, when you were in Pulukwane as the moderator of your church. We were saddened by the lack of your visits. Because of the time schedule that you had, we could not get hold of you. Now that you're back, we are happy. Thank you so much. I'm winding time, waiting for the graduates to come in. As you heard from the end of the formation phase, we have come to celebrate that these children have completed the school readiness program. They have been busy with that program for the whole year. And today, on the 1st of December, they graduate from the program. We are very proud of these young boys and girls. I can assure you, the doctor said universities are characterized by development of mind of students. The doc is he will be responsible for the graduation. I'll be simply calling the names. He will be handing over the certificates. I will humbly invite him to come up the stage. Thank you. The universities, they are Tina Jazz. Why did we not make sure that we also dress? Even if we are not doctors, but we should dress. I remember. Next time, carry a bar and my jazz number band. If you were to ask me what are the characteristics of university students today, I would tell you, if you wake me up and ask me that question, I would say strikes, uprooting robots. And obviously, Muslim Nedich Mwanamachu delivered to Tupukani as a robot. Do you know what my conclusions are? As much as our government has opened the university doors and gates for many people who would not have afforded the opportunity to study at the universities, but at the same time, it has opened university doors for people who don't deserve to be at the universities. They are there for nurses. They are failing to come nice. They strike at everything that comes up. They wish there should be something they should be striking for. I would love to see university students exchanging ideas with their leaders for whatever problem there is and resolve it through ideas, exchange of ideas. The universities are staffed with students who don't belong there. As much as the government is looking after the poor of the poorest, abantu fanele ubana bana bana uri bawane ndende. Children should be born into families because parents want these children into their families. Not because these children will be used as a key to government stipend. You will not find these kids uprooting the robots. As not the children who are not going to be the robot. Mostly, those are the students that are failing their courses. And they have to find something that makes up for their lack of passing. Mubuso uzongo chapa mutu mwe na mwe nefsas. Kau eba tuba neba kutota uya ukuda. Vanodota ava vene za shangolash. We're wasting a lot of money funding wrong people. One last thing. There was a time when many people were brought into leadership in the education sector. And because the unions were leading, and their people, most of the people were not educated from unions. Article 7 about the union. And many were placed in leadership. Most of the children, even in secondary grade, 10 and 1 up over and 1. It's happening. Because wrong teachers are standing in front of children in classes. Education should be fruitful to those that are there to learn. It's very difficult for us to find teachers these days. You advertise a post. Applications come in, you interview, you never get a teacher. So these are some of the things that I thought I should say, because we are spending a lot of resources. The robot is not closed, the doors are replacing. The spot of the doors are replacing. Taxi, don't go, no go. High carry measure. Now my time, Doc, Reverend. It's now the time to celebrate these young ones who will never uproot the robots. Do we uproot robots? We don't. Now I'm calling all names who will. I'll simply shake your hand and then you will move to the reverend who is dressed just like you to hand over your school readiness certificate. You have achieved school readiness and he will be handing over your certificate. The first person is Ali Asher or Asher.
Thank you.
next one, Budeli Orifunaho. Starting with your surname and then your name. The next one, Kampa Anzachiriti. The next one, Kavatundwi Ompa. Panda Denje. The next one, Panda Denje. They are very confident. But to cover the world, they are going to be proud of it.
Yes, we are.
Yeah, I. We should be a cold dog. The next one, Mafadza Mranga.
Marubini wa
the mudoro of principal. The next one, Mashatini Rotorua. The next one, Masia Gwara Murendeni. Adiba Koror. Vajvas.
Can we do that? Thank you.
Mukwebo Nduvo. Vasokori ego rendia mrauzi ine rakotanga noidi vava saidivi ngauri kana nuri vone va mrauzi ava vanthu vanga vava mrauzi naka ubati vanga matoza mrauzi andisa chiridzi Mulaudzi orifuna. Vako vamona mulaudzi. Vasirias mulaudzi apa. Murobeti ori dedeta. Mushanganyisi vukoni.
Singo To our teachers, thank you for You taught us to tie our shoes. You taught us shapes and colors. You taught us many things. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Thank you to our parents for waking us up. Also to take us to school. Also to prepare our lunch boxes. Thank you.
To Chicken Master, thank you all for being there for us. You taught us to be okay. You taught us to laugh. You taught us to pray. You taught us to be strong. Thank you everyone for all you have done. Great 1 year of time.
Who is giving words of thanks and announcements. Let's welcome her with a big round of applause.
Greetings to you all in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Let me take this opportunity to thank you all for gracing this very important function. I also want to welcome the teachers who have been invigilating exam in our high school section. They have just joined us. Mr. Mawarre and your team, you are welcome. Your good timing for lunch. A graduate program of this magnitude cannot be successful without the support of stakeholders like you all seated here. This is the reason why you all deserve our special thanks today. And I also thank the Almighty God for seeing us through this successful day. You all agree with me, this event was successful, isn't it?
Yes.
I'd like to thank the organizers of this event for pulling it together and making it successful. Let me take the opportunity to thank the grade R teachers. You have seen their works. Miss Nube and Miss Mutira, who calls herself a princess. Expected. They have invested their energy, their skills, and knowledge into the kids. We have seen that through their presentations. Today, the learners are a marvel to watch and listen to. The teachers made the learners we all want to see and we all want to have in our classes. There is an African proverb or an adage which says, it takes a village to raise a child. Today, that village that raises the kid is all of you seated there. Many special thanks go to our pastor, our Reverend Dr. Muntari. This is not the first time he has raised an event like this for our school. We have invited them previously to be a guest speaker in our graduation ceremony. He has never been disappointed like you have witnessed today. Thank you even for conferring the certificates that the learners were receiving. Let me say your presentation was an eye-opener to all parents and teachers. We are hoping we will not have social media influenced issues from these learners in our classes as from next year, because their parents are well equipped today and they will be cooking. Are you not going to cook for these learners, parents? That's not loud enough. Are we saying we are not gifted in the kitchen? With all these air fryers and other kitchen equipment, we can't make it. I trust that next year we'll have children who will have proper lunch tins in their bags. I want to thank the following people also. Mr. Musa, who gave the opening prayer. The little one from grade R class, Ludotwa, who welcomed us in a special way. She is a speaker in the parliament in the making. Ms. Lo, who formally introduced the guest speaker, and Ms. Munoria Roa for explaining to us the purpose of this gathering. She is the mentor behind the two program directors. Shall we applaud her, please? To our principal, Mr. Rashifumo, we appreciate your presence and we thank you for your availability to read the names as the certificates were handed over. I would like in the same vein to thank the program directors, Orifuna and Ndiwo, for a stunning job in directing this program. They do say that dynamite comes in small packages. And last but not the least, the grade R learners themselves. They worked hard and they deserve a pat on the back. Today, they're reaping the fruits of the hard work they did in the class. And we thank the parents who are the undisputed champions of support for the grade R class. We thank you again for obeying our request for different items and clothes for presentation. You made this day successful. Reverend Doctor said, parents are co-workers with God in raising these children. Let's keep that in our minds and thank you again. In anticipation, I will thank Ms. Rajtanga, who is going to present to close this session with a prayer. I'm also requested to make an announcement. There is only maybe two announcements that I will make concerning refreshments. All parents will move to the dining hall where refreshments are prepared for us. However, we request that you allow those who will show us the way to take the lead and you follow them as they take you table by table so that we do not overcrowd the place. We have done it previously, the guest and the principal always leave the hall first. Our ushers will take them there. Then the parents will follow. Our teachers always serve themselves last. Lastly, I'm not sure if Bulisani was streaming live this event, but if it's not, it's going to be uploaded on YouTube. You will see it. If you prefer, you can also buy this footage from the school. You contact us, we will give it to you. That is why we said we do not want people who will come with cameras to take videos. Our learners will be taken care of by the teachers. I wish you a safe festive season and a blessed new year. Thank you very much.
Coming up next is Ms. Rachid Tanga, and who is coming to close for us with a word of prayer. Let's give a big round of applause as she comes for the speaker.
Our very special principal, Mr. Raj Bomo, including our guest speaker, and of course our graduates. Please join me in prayer as we bow our heads and pray for our little ones. Father, we thank you. We thank you for grace and for mercy. We thank you for the academic year that it has been. We thank you for our graduates. Our graduates are ready to go. We pray, Father, that you give them more grace and courage. As they have worked hard to meet their readiness for this graduation, thank you, Father, for protecting our learners and guiding them to this point. Inspire them, Lord, to put to good use all the knowledge, skills, and life lessons they have gained. As they start a new journey with their known journey challenges, help them face, Father. As they start a new journey with their known challenges, help them face, Father, these challenges, knowing who they are in Christ and in the power of the cross. As they close their school readiness chapter, pave their road with opportunities and inspire them to live with hope in this incredible journey called life. Continue to bless them with love, strength, mercy, wisdom, and cover them with divine protection. Thank you for their teachers. Bless them, Father, for they have done a great job with our graduates. Let them have big hearts to continue teaching and producing results as we have seen today. Father, as we leave this venue, as we come to an end to this program, lead us, Father, on our way home and in everything else that we'll be doing. Thank you, Father, for everything that you've blessed us with, and please continue blessing us. In your name we pray. Amen.
Oh, I will sing of the goodness of God.
Cause all my-